Good afternoon, everybody. This is Joseph Boone. Welcome to the Phantom Side Channel. And we're here with a reaction to GameCon. The year it come up again to see what game is coming this year or next year or the year after that. So, let's begin right now. Okay, if you probably want to know what happened, I skipped the, countdown and stuff. Okay, 18 plus.
Use your mind. It's Gamescom.
Alright.
Welcome to the Gamescom Opening Night Live pre-show. I'm Kyle Bossman, and I'm going to be
building
anticipation in these final few moments leading up to the big show itself, Gamescom Opening Night Live 2024.
Yay!
Here's the weird thing about the pre-show this year. We have more games in this pre-show than ever before. And a bunch of them are brand new game announcements. That's mucho.
Okay.
Street Fighter 6 showed up for this. The pre-show is good. So let's get it started. We're talking about Dave the Diver first, who's had some fun and unpredictable collaborations already this year, but he's not done yet. Let's see what Dave's getting into next.
Okay, Dave the Diver. All right.
I'm Maya.
I could be hyped for this game, but again, it's gotta be on Nintendo Switch, so I might, it might be a little game. Like, it might be a game I might play by myself, for real. Huh? Oh, yeah. What do you guys think about this game? Like, Potion Craft. They got Potion Craft? Coming
if you're just joining us here at the pre-show, you're still relatively early. You only missed one trailer so far. And our next one is for a brand new game in a storied franchise, well known for its depiction of long-distance relationships.
Okay, this game, I might see it probably be on PS4. PS5, or it might be on Nintendo Switch.
Desperate to turn the tide of war back in their favor, the French resistance have uncovered a rumor of a secret weapon so ruthless, so severe, it could make it impossible to reclaim France. This threat can't go ignored.
Gun move! Spear Elite.
Welcome back to the opening night live 2024 pre-show. The main event is close. It will have the big games. It will have the big game announcements. But for now, this pre-show is bustling along. Up next, a brand new trailer for Begone Beast.
Okay. Beware. Ooh. Yep, this game might be on Nintendo Switch or PC. Now, what is that? Oh, heck no. Oh no, bro. What the world? Oh! Be gone, beast.
Yep, I knew it. PC, which is now streaming.
Trust me on this. You're about to see the most thrilling trailer for a road-building simulator you've ever seen in your life, right now.
When I was a kid, I couldn't wait to leave this town behind. But what's that saying? Man plans and God laughs.
Focus.
He must have had a good one on my account. When the water receded, it carried away everything we ever had. It also gave me a reason to stay. Truth is, we can't stop what's coming. The important thing is that we rebuild.
So, okay, a new similar game, I guess. Rowcraft, clear and support and rebuild. 2025, which is now, it gotta be on Xbox, PS5, and PC.
And now you're
about
to see a couple of games that will make you say,
okay. Oh, this is like, hello. Okay. Oh. It's one of those games. October.
The Hound of War chases the scent, oblivious to the Master's leash. True balance lies beyond the edge of a blade. Do not take free will for granted. I know I did.
The last song. Oop. All right. Okay. I might be high when this one come out. Yep. September 19, 2024. Oh.
We all agree that this pre-show is going pretty good so far, but my primary duty here is to make you aware of and excited about the fact that opening night live is minutes away. So here they are. The top 10 reasons to look forward to Gamescom Opening Night Live 2024. Number 10. A new look at Call of Duty Black Ops 6.
Okay, okay.
Number 9, an extended look at the gameplay of Dune Awakening.
All right. I never watched the Dune movies.
Until the second movie, and now I think Dune is cool. Number 8.
I think I need, yeah. Oh my god, that should be me.
The king-like power you feel when dozens of big-budget games desperately beg you to wishlist them.
Okay.
Number 7 reason to look forward to Gamescom Opening Night Live 2024. News from Marvel Rivals.
All right. They watch the Marvel, so yeah, I'm excited.
Indiana Jones and the Great Circle presentation. Because there's no way it's just another super long cutscene. At some point, they're going to have to show what it's like to play this game. Like, what button is the whip? Number 5.
That's funny.
The reveal of Tarsier Studios' next game. Here's the story with this one. So, Tarsier Studios, who made the Little Nightmares games, a few weeks ago, they put out this terrifying teaser with, like, this sliced open giant happy pig. And then it just says, Worldwide Game Reveal, Gamescom ONL. And that makes me curious. I don't even know what this is. Number 4 reason to look forward to Gamescom Opening Night Live.
So call back to the careers that play Little Night.
50-50 careers that made Little Nightmare. Shows up with a new dance. Just to be clear here, he is not scheduled to appear. But you always feel like there's a chance. Number 3. The first gameplay of Civilization 7. Number 2. On Monster Hunter Wilds.
Okay, I'm hyped for that. What they gotta do for that?
There's no way it's just gonna be somebody talking. I promise it's gonna be nice. And the number one reason to look forward to Gamescom Opening Night Live 2024 is... It is always nice to hear a room full of people cheer and be happy about video games. Almost always.
Yep.
But before we can get to any of that, there's still plenty of pre-show to go. Next up, from the studio behind Fury and Haven, here's a brand new trailer for Cairn.
Okay, this is nice. Yep, okay. And it looks beautiful too. Shoot. Time me up for this one.
Are you ready for Cammy? It doesn't look so bad, does it?
Wish this on stream. Play it at GameCon.
This next part is cool. You're going to see a mysterious trailer for an unannounced game, and then immediately after that, I have an interview with that game's developer.
So
first, here's this.
How long has it been? 5 days? 6? I need to get up. But no matter how much I sleep, I still feel tired.
Oh my god, what is this? What is this game? Feel
unsettling.
What is this? What the fuck?
The only thing that brings me a bit of comfort is that I'll never talk to another human being ever again. I've decided that this abandoned farm will be the place where I die. But until then, that leaves me with an ever-pressing question. How do I fill the time? There's always a lot to do on a farm.
It's in first person?
It's gonna keep busy. It gets your mind off things, like the things you've lost.
The first tree.
We'll see what winter brings.
We have we haven't shadowed.
Recently, play the demo on stream.
Oh my god.
The solo developer behind We Harvest Shadows, David Whaley.
What's up? Thanks for having me. It's a great honor.
Okay, we got David Whaley.
How would you label We Harvest Shadows?
We Harvest Shadows is officially, I call it, a first-person farming horror allegory.
Okay, so it's a farming and half horror.
Things with this game. I wanted to make a beautiful horror game. It's very personal, story-wise. I call it anti-cozy game, which you're probably wondering, how does that even work? I think a lot of us, we had a hard time during the pandemic, and, you know, like Animal Crossing, like that saved my life.
Extremely cozy.
Yes, extremely cozy. And I was like, I wonder if we can take this type of gameplay, which is relaxing, and twist it in an unusual way to make a gameplay experience that's unlike anything else. And so I want this game to be relaxing, but I also want it to be terrifying.
So I think an interesting part of that trailer is when you get your first objective on that notepad and it just says leave house, which seems like a simple thing, but I'm wondering in the game itself, is it going to be like a mechanically difficult thing to do?
That is interesting.
You know, I don't want to spoil anything, but in the trailer, I wanted to show this main character, his mental state and how his capacity is different. And maybe sometimes we want to judge people that, like, oh, they can't leave the house, what's the big deal? But I've had days like that where that's the hardest thing in the world. And I wanted these mental hurdles to become real. Like, they're figurative challenges, but they become like literal challenges and sometimes literal demons in the game.
I've been there where leave house is a difficult objective of the day. I've been there.
Yep, me too.
Oh, I get that. What is something from that trailer you hope people didn't miss?
There is like some hidden things in the trailer. There might be
like
some,
what?
Yeah, there might be some eagle-eyed viewers, but a big theme of the game is that he wants to be alone forever, right? But he's actually being watched at all times. And so in the trailer, there's a lot of hidden faces, scary things looking at him. So maybe people can go back and see if they can find him.
David Whaley, thank you so much for joining us. Have a great Gamescom.
Thank you so
much. Okay, we had Daily Whaley.
Thanks again to David for taking the time to do this and bringing the vibes back up. And I think
now
is as good a time as any for a super scary trailer with biblical undertones.
Fireship Games, Bubba Studios.
Doesn't present itself.
I love this already. What is it? What name is this game right here?
But I will reveal to you the real horror.
Guys, I already like this game already. What name is it? VR? VR? That is not VR. Yep. Coming 2025. Wishes now stream.
Bellissimo. Next up is a trailer that works better if I don't even set it up. So here's a good trailer to watch.
Stuck on a planet with nowhere to poop.
The juiciest burgers in the galaxy. Burger Squirt.
Flappy Extreme Burden Smart Bot from Hot Wheels.
What the hell?
I smush it down my throat.
What?
New Ding Dong!
Brave Explorer. We here at Alta Interglobal would like to welcome you to our newest venture.
I guess that was just some random stuff.
The colonization of space. You've spent almost a century hurtling through the universe in cryosleep, ready to begin your work on this strange alien planet. Unfortunately, changing market conditions have led us to the realization that space exploration is far too costly and unpredictable, and Alta has decided to cancel all future plans in space. I regret to inform you that you have therefore been made redundant. Your final check has been sent. We thank you for your service, and we hope you eventually find a way home. Good luck.
We're back for number two. Single player, online, crossplayer, split screen, no game. Okay! Defense of the survival planet. Turn into Xbox Live. Stream tomorrow, August 21st, for the full
game.
Next
up, we've got Inzoi, which is a new life sim game. It's like The Sims, but more beautiful. If you are interested in getting a head start on creating your characters,
yep,
this next trailer is for
yep,
you.
Yep, okay. Tell me about The Sims. Come on. All right, but you say we upgraded. You say we're upgrading. All right. Yep, keep bringing up a brusca. Yep, we upgrade, okay. They said this is the live action version. Inzoi characters do arrive on stream. Yep, I see me playing this on Nintendo Switch. Oh. Okay, all right. When it's coming. Just show me when it's coming. This is on stream. Also be on.
Yeah. Opening Night Live 2024 pre-show, where we are getting people excited for a big night of video game trailers by showing you more and more game trailers. And next up is another brand new game announcement.
I've always wanted to fly. The joy of it, the freedom of it. To just take your life in your hands and soar. I think that's in us all, isn't it? At least that's what my dad taught me.
Oh no, what the world? Coming 2025.
This
is now.
But we have just one trailer left in this pre-show. You might remember, back at Summer Game Fest, Capcom announced that Terry Bogard would be joining Season 2 of Street Fighter 6.
Not Terry Bogard.
Last month at Evo, we all got to see what his in-game character model looks like. But tonight, now, in this moment, Terry's about to power dunk all doubts. Here is the Street Fighter VI Terry Bogard gameplay reveal.
Ooh, all right, this looks good. This looks good. Ooh. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Street Fighter.
Good stuff, Terry. And that's it for the pre-show. Gamescom Opening Night Live 2024 is now officially just seconds away. Thank you for hanging out with me here and Mucho, too. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching.
Okay, time for the real thing to happen.
Guten Abend, Gamescom! And hello to everyone watching around the world. This is Opening Night Live from beautiful Cologne, Germany. And we have our biggest live audience of fans ever here at Kölnmesse, over 5,000 people together as a community to celebrate our love of games. And of course, millions of you watching online around the world, welcome. We have gathered for the grand kickoff to Gamescom, the world's biggest in-person video game event. And this is our sixth Opening Night Live. Now tonight, for the first time, we have a live sign language stream of ONL to make the show even more accessible. Thank you to Kaborski, who's signing the show right now. Thank you, Kaborski.
All right, Kaborski, all right.
Now, while the game industry certainly has faced challenges this year, I know that ONL will get you excited about what's to come later this year and in 2025 and beyond. Now, over the next 2 hours, you're gonna see world premieres from studios big and small, including, yes, some new game announcements you're not expecting, and some surprises, so get ready. From Monster Hunter to Indiana Jones, Dune to Civilization, Call of Duty to Marvel Rivals, the most anticipated games will be on stage tonight because they wanted to be here with you guys at Gamescom, and I am so honored and grateful to have the opportunity present these games to you. So Gamescom, sind Sie bereit für die World Premiere? I tried it. All right, here's our first World Premiere, a brand new game announcement. This one hasn't leaked and it's exclusive right here at ONL.
K game persons a Gadgetbot software game. I'm gonna be aside when this game comes. Like, it looks good.
Hello.
Dune, Board Riser, 4, 2025, what's this now?
There you go, all right, that's right, Borderlands 4 is coming in 2025. Next up, October 25th marks the release of Call of Duty Black Ops 6. To debut an extended look at the campaign gameplay, please welcome John Zuck and Catherine Anderson from Raven Software.
Okay.
Black Ops returns with an epic story and signature blockbuster action where players question everything and trust no one. It features an all-new campaign with 16 new multiplayer maps, with a return of classic prestige and theater mode, and two brand new zombies experiences on day one. You'll see live MP, zombies, and Warzone gameplay at the Call of Duty Next event on August 28th. And starting on August 30th, you'll be able to join the MP open beta to try out the brand new Omni movement system for yourself. But today, we're here representing the Raven team, who's leading the campaign in partnership with Treyarch.
The Black Ops 6 campaign is set in the early 90s, a time of global turmoil and uncertainty as the Cold War comes to an end. You're joined by legendary characters Frank Woods, the Grizzled Vet, and Russell Adler, the ultimate wild card. Together with new allies Troy Marshall and Jane Harrow, and unbound by normal rules of engagement, you'll a mind-bending conspiracy. In the mission we're about to show you, our rogue team has targeted a senator attending a political fundraiser in order to gain access to a top-secret black site underneath Washington, D.C.
This is Most Wanted.
So we're going to show up to this fundraiser, get what we need from the senator, then grab Adler from the black site before anyone knows what's happened. The camera actually works.
Sometimes I surprise even myself.
Let's just hope Sav and Case can get the retinal scan.
Senator's on stage now. Use your camera to get a better look. The senator isn't giving interviews tonight, and he doesn't go anywhere without his security detail. I've marked a few leads that could help get you close enough to do the retinal scan. Take your pick.
I got it on good authority that the senator stole some sensitive information from the people I work for.
How are you?
Blackmailing the senator with sex tapes. Can't beat the classics.
I've cleaned up another of your messes.
Lee Grisham, head of security for Aldrin Energy.
Grisham might be our way to McKenna.
Oh. Okay, that was sick. Take a picture, say cheese.
I modified the infrared image to highlight the capillaries in the senator's retina. It should have just enough resolution.
Okay, all right.
ain't gonna stop spinning. Guys literally sent the big guns after you, Adler. How's that feel?
Like progress.
Up through the service hatch. You two first. I'll give you a boost. You first, Adler. Come on, Case. Down. Here. Almost home free.
Oh. Nope. 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 Yep. Yeah, this is it.
Yeah, we're ready for X-Field. What's the
this
play?
This is it.
No play. This place is surrounded by cops. We can't beat you.
Damn. If we can't outgun them, we outrun them.
Just like that, huh?
Just like that.
Ever do anything like this before?
No. But I don't see any better options, and I'm running out of bullets.
Pantheon, 10 o'clock.
Keep them off!
Call of Duty Black Ops 6 pre-order now. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna be hyped when that game come out. I'm gonna be hyped when that game come out too.
There you go, Black Ops 6, more coming at Call of Duty next. And now I'm honored to introduce my co-host for Opening Night Live. You know her from her years of hosting League of Legends esports around the world. Did you know that she got her start as a competitive Unreal Tournament player? That's right. Please join me in welcoming to ONL, Shox.
And hello, Gamescom. Thank you for the warm welcome. Unreal Tournament, that is quite the throwback, but I am so excited to be here tonight revealing many of the games on Opening Night Live and highlighting events happening during this Gamescom week in Cologne. Gamescom really is the best week for games worldwide every year, and I am so stoked to be back here with you all celebrating it. Now, it is my pleasure to share a message from Gamescom to you, our gaming community.
Dear future me, I hope you are happy.
I hope you visit wonderful places, that you have friends from places far away, and that you always have the best adventures, that you fight for the things you love, and that you love the things you do. Dear future me, my favorite thing in the world is to play. Do you like to play too?
Yes, the future is here, and we are ready to play. Let's take a look at this fun trailer. Join us virtually by going to Gamescom Global, where you can explore and discover what the world's gaming industry has in store for you. And our very own Gamescom Studio is here with all-day coverage of the event, so tune in to Gamescom Studio's broadcast by IGN on Twitch or on YouTube. Now, we have some news on Persona yeah. 3 Reload and its next DLC episode, Aegis, The Answer. Coming on September 10th. It's time to reveal a surprising boss fight coming to the game.
Tomorrow and all the days after it will be March 31st.
It's like Tartarus all over again.
There is a strong connection between all of you and what's happening.
Let's just open it, then we'll know. Something's wrong.
Ravage them!
You'll never see it coming.
Joker fun there. Alright. Next up, we have another new game announcement for you right here, exclusively at Gamescom Opening Night Live.
The tracks lead this way. Thank God.
daylight, the beast.
There you go. Kyle Crane is back in a new zombie adventure set in the Dying Light world with 20 hours of gameplay, a new open world region, and more in Dying Light, the Beast. Next, today marks the launch for the most wishlisted game right now on Steam, and also, last I checked, the biggest single-player game ever on Steam with over 2 million concurrent players today, Black Myth Wukong from Game Science in China, which is also out on the PlayStation 5. And right now, we've got the reveal of the launch trailer for you.
Yep. Yep, this game already looks scary. Yep. Ooh. 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 Yes, sir. Yep. August 20th, 2024.
Ah,
okay, another Dragon Ball game. Okay, that game might, yeah, that game might be, that's a future gameplay to play on the can- oh.
Welcome back to Gamescom Opening Night Live, here in beautiful Murdoch.
Who's ready to run?
Commercial.
From the Construct Coliseum, it's time for everyone's favorite game, Join recently kidnapped celebrity guest contender Jeff Keighley at the starting line.
Wait, starting line?
And that battle cry proves how committed Jeff is to any project. Let's check the soosh with our sideline reporter.
This dungeon is throwing everything at these contenders, but the JK machine is leading the way to the finish line, and the chat is blowing.
What is all this? Death traps, unapproved nicknames, and a giant horse trying to hoof me?
An eloquent and marketing-friendly description of the game, not to mention a perfectly timed transition to the world premiere trailer for King of Meat!
Ready for action? Ready for mayhem? Ready for gold and fame pouring from the sky? Challenges from the most twisted minds of the most ghoulish dungeon creators are transformed into monstrous reality. It's like a nightmare in dungeon form. This is King
got it, Keely. Still got it.
Welcome back to Opening Night Live for real this time. And that was the announcement of King of Meat, an online co-op spectacle for 1 to 4 players from Glowmade, Guildford, England, and Amazon Games for console and PC. You can sign up at kingofmeat.com for future playtests. Now, one of the things I absolutely love about making these shows is that we get to introduce you to brand new games and teams, like this one, to reveal their first game from their new studio, FuzzyBot. Please welcome Tatiana Dislova and Max Spielberg.
Ooh.
Guys, welcome to ONL. I'm very excited to share this game with the world. Can you tell us a little bit about your studio, first of all?
Yeah, well, first off, it's totally surreal to be here right now. We started the studio back in 2020, and the majority of us had come from the AAA side of the industry. And at the time, we were just thrilled to have our own game, our own IP, and we could never expect being on the stage tonight at the end of that run.
The vision for our studio started with the idea of dreaming big and building smart. The concept for our first game, even early on, felt very unique and full of heart, and this helped us bring together a very passionate team of talented developers. It's through their skill, dedication, and true love for the game that we're able to be here tonight, going way beyond where we thought we'd be.
Well, I got to play this a few months ago with you guys. I had a ton of fun. Tell us a bit about your game, Linked.
Yeah, so our debut game is called Linked, Banner of the Spark. It's a co-op action hack and slash with a bit of roguelite and town building elements. And so we blended these ideas together to create this cozy yet highly kinetic action game for players to brawl, build, and befriend a crew of adorable robots. In it, it's the year 3000, and you're gonna take on the role as one of the last remaining humans on planet Earth. Allying with a friendly bot faction, you're gonna aim to take down the Combot Army hell-bent on organic destruction. Players can play alone or with friends in this vibrant world of robots.
Or a simpler way that I like to describe it sometimes is you go out and fight the evil robots and then collect their body parts to build a sustainable town of your dreams while saving the cute ones. We are incredibly proud to finally reveal the delightful world of Linked, Banner of the Spark, and we hope the players get as much joy out of playing it as we have building it.
Well, we're very excited to show to the world for the first time. Let's take a look at the world premiere reveal trailer. Thanks, guys.
On this fact, fishing makes every video game better. Now, one of the things that I love about Gamescom is that it is a safe place for our diverse gaming family. And there is an amazing platform called Gamescom Cares that shares social and environmental responsibility projects that we care deeply about, thanks to all of our partners who help to make this happen. You can learn more by scanning the QR code below. And now, the first look at the gameplay of Lost Records, Bloom and Rage, a narrative adventure from the creative minds behind Life is Strange.
Honestly, Swan, I'm glad, but slightly surprised that you showed up tonight.
Yep.
When I saw your text, all these memories came flooding back.
A Murray hyper-ray.
Hey, she actually showed. Welcome!
I remembered Nora, her energy.
Shit! Oh, where's my fucking pick?
The Tharp one's her favorite. I remembered you.
Nice one, Autumn.
You were the coolest.
Skateboarder's wisdom. Never land on your wrist.
I want to see you skateboard, Autumn. I remembered Kat.
Whoa, watch out!
She was like a firecracker.
Fuck!
This is serious. We're gonna need a real band name.
How about Bloom and Rage?
How could I forget? Last week, my mom found a package on her doorstep. Wait, are Bloom and Rage? Are we in trouble?
You'll excuse me if today's sermon is a little different, but today is not a normal Sunday.
Looks great. It's a new look at the 8-player co-op of No More Room in Hell 2 from Torn Banner up in Canada, where there are deadly consequences of not sticking close to your teammates, and I cannot wait to check that one out. All right, our next game, it's been a long time coming for this next one. At the Game Awards in 2021, Embark Studios revealed Arc Raiders, a game that immediately struck a chord with players around the globe, a stunning future Earth where menacing Arc machines threaten humanity's attempts to rebuild. Well, Arc Raiders has evolved a lot since then, and now it's finally time for some news on what's next for this exciting action survival shooter.
Where do we go from here? You've told us nothing of this place.
Okay, I'm gonna be hyped when this game comes out. Big time.
What you saw right there was Predecessor, a MOBA shooter built by an indie team from the ashes of Epic Games' Paragon, if you remember that one. It enters 1.0 free-to-play release tonight. Next up, Path of Exile 2 from Grinding Gear Games. It is nearing release, and tonight, yes, we do have news on the early access date. Check this out.
My son, are you clear of mind? And stout of heart.
I am.
Are you ready to sacrifice? Sacrifice everything to become the savior?
I will.
Do you have the strength to sweep aside this world and build it anew?
I must.
Are you ready to fulfill your destiny?
Path of Exile. Yeah, you can see me there.
I'm ready.
November 15, 2024, Easy Crossing.
Great, can't wait for that one. And now, Gamescom is known for the cosplay. The vision and dedication cosplayers put into their craft is an inspiration to us all. And to see these amazing cosplayers, you can tune in to the Gamescom Cosplay Awards on Saturday, August 24th at 5 p.m. And if you're into indie games, who isn't, you can watch the best indies of Gamescom in our Gamescom Awesome Indie Show tomorrow at 8 p.m. on Twitch and YouTube. Enjoy exclusive announcements and interviews all packed into an exciting one-hour show hosted by Shay Thompson. Plus, the Gamescom Event Arena, that is where I am standing right now and all of you are. It is the biggest and most elaborate stage at Gamescom, featuring not only Opening Night Live, but additional live shows featuring creators, gaming events, and esports competitions that you can watch either in person or by tuning in online. Now, up next is a first look at the gameplay of June Awakening.
Yeah!
Open World Survival MMO. And news on when it's going to be released.
There is another path for you.
Yep.
Awaken.
Begin as a nameless prisoner. Sculpt your appearance, choose your background, and then crash into the planet. You are abandoned and alone. Hunted by sandworms. Scorched by the unforgiving sun. Ravaged by sunstroke. Stick to the shade. Chase the moving shadows. Survive. Welcome to Arrakis, the most dangerous planet in the universe. Meet hundreds of other players in the vast online world. Befriend or betray those you meet. Form a wary alliance. In this case, a spit dart rifle and a stillsuit for your help taking down territorial deserters. Working with others will always increase your chance of staying alive. The deserter base. Climb to a vantage point and prepare for violence. Your choice of weapons and abilities determines your strategy. Swordmasters lead the charge into battle, literally. Repel ranged attacks with a shield and then take them out, one by one. Deploy the Hunter Seeker and kill from the shadows. Take what you can from the fall. On Arrakis, nothing of value is wasted. Mine, harvest, and gather with your group to build bases and unlock more advanced equipment, like the blood purifier. Refine the blood you collected from your enemies to extract drinkable water. Craft improved equipment using fabricators. Replicate your bases in new locations with the blueprint system, and then sell blueprints of your architectural wonders to other players. Lead your group to become a guild. On Arrakis, a nameless prisoner can rise. Construct an ornithopter and take to the air. The world is yours to claim.
This is Dune Man Keefilari reminding you today of return of the Force Spice Lord. My crew found a shortcut. We become comfortable.
The in-game radio provides insight into key events happening across Arrakis. Map the desert. Discover landmarks, wrecked ships, and desert testing stations filled with forgotten technology. Arrakis is a vast planet. You can explore unique locations, uncover valuable resources, and search for secrets amongst the shifting dunes. And then return to civilization triumphant with what you found. Harko Village throngs with people, spice traders, guild bankers, smugglers, house envoys, and of course, other players. Here, you will pledge allegiance to one of the great houses of Dune, the Harkonnen. But remember, to play politics, you need power. And on Arrakis, spice is power.
Power.
For the landscape, hunting for spice. Every spice blow has the potential to become a heated battle, with multiple guilds vying for the precious melange. Even when it looks like defeat is inevitable, those who understand desert power can awaken Arrakis itself.
Well, yep.
Well, you can't have a Dune game without the sandworms, and the sandworm summoning begins. Drops on PC early 2025, so the wait is not that long. And now, here is a reveal of a new game from Tarsier Studios, the creators of Little Nightmares 1 and 2.
All right, let's see what they got going on. So it's about a pig.
Unless
nothing lasts forever.
Wow.
I thought you were dead.
Wishes now. All right.
Reanimal. Entry in the cozy game genre. Now, would you like to discover the secret contents of Gamescom and receive cool rewards? Well, meet Epi, the robot on our website RPG Gamescom Epics. Prove your nerd know-how, solve tricky puzzles, win prizes, gather trading cards, digital trading cards, and jump from level to level until the final boss spawns. Scan the QR code below and the adventure can begin. Now in its fourth year as an evolving open-world adventure, today Genshin Impact is unveiling more about the sixth nation of Natlan, which will be released on August 28th. And we also have some news about when the game will be coming to Xbox.
Oh, more about this game.
There you go, Genshin Impact, and also coming to Xbox later this year, as we saw. All right, now it's time to head into the wilds of Monster Hunter, which is playable for fans
for
the first time. Here at Gamescom, Capcom has an incredible booth. But now, to tell us more and show us more, please welcome to the Gamescom ONL stage, Ryozo Tsujimoto from Capcom. Ryozo-san.
All right.
Hello to all of my friends in Germany and to the millions watching around the globe. I'm really thankful that Jeff has invited me to the opening night live stage so I can share a new Monster Hunter Wilds trailer with everyone.
今日のですね、今回ですね、ゲームズコンでは初のプレイヤブル出展も行っています。今後ですね、世界のいろんな様々な地域でこのようなプレイヤブルの出展も考えていますので、そちらも期待していただけたらと思います。それでは最新の映像をご覧ください。
Before we debut the trailer, I just want to express how excited I am to kick off our season of Monster Hunter Wilds hands-on demos starting at Gamescom. Now, let's take a look at the latest trailer.
Woo!
My word. Is this a Lalabarina florist? We must be near its nest.
Monster Hunter Leaves. Okay. Also known Monster Hunter have a cooking system.
So tasty!
2025, what's this now?
Danger lies at every turn. Treasure.
This is now on Xbox PC. All right.
That was a new look at Mecha Break, the multiplayer mech game. Okay, next, we have something exciting for fans of Monument Valley, the beautiful twisted puzzle game that we all played about a decade ago when it was first released in 2014. Well, tonight, we are revealing Monument Valley 3, coming later this year from Us2 in London and Netflix Games. I played this. It is an absolutely beautiful, stunning game, and we've got your first look right now.
Monument Valley 3 drops exclusively on Netflix December 10th, 2024. Now, first released in 1991, Civilization is one of the gaming industry's biggest franchises. And here at Gamescom, we are revealing the gameplay of Civilization 7 for the first time. To tell us more, please welcome Ed Beach from Firaxis Games.
All right.
Thank you, Shox. Thank you, Gamescom. It's hard to believe that it's been almost 8 years since Firaxis released our last Civilization game. So we're incredibly honored to be here tonight at Gamescom talking about Civilization 7. Civ 7. Civ 7 is by far the biggest, most ambitious game Firaxis has ever made. Everything from its new gameplay features to its gorgeous new art style is designed to immerse you in your own journey through history. Please join us after opening night live on the Firaxis Game Twitch channel for our official gameplay showcase, where we'll deep dive into what's new in Civ 7 and finally reveal our new in-game narrator. On behalf of the team at Firaxis Games, who has worked so hard on this game, I'm so excited to finally give the world its first look at Sid Meier's Civilization VII. Please, enjoy.
Civilization was a game that was created during a time when we were just discovering what games could be. And we said, let's put the entire history of the world into a game and make it fun.
Thank you.
since we first reached for the stars. We've been asking ourselves, what else is out there? And more importantly,
okay.
Two bits of Starfield news for you and a confirmation of the expansion Shattered Space that is coming out on September 30th. Now it's time for an exclusive update on Marvel Rivals, the upcoming hero
Yes. Shooter
from NetEase Games and Marvel Games. Tonight at ONL, we're revealing two new heroes who are joining the game with a first look at their gameplay.
Among the stars, Wakanda found a new home and a new hope. The source of vibranium, the foundation of an empire.
Snap out of it, Bucky.
So fast!
Your battle's over.
Stick around!
Armed and dangerous!
This is so crazy.
Together! To victory!
Together! To victory!
I'm sure everyone who played the beta wanted to know Marvel Rivals will launch on December 6, 2024. Now, Gamescom always strives to help the environment, and the event runs on 100% renewable energy and is climate-friendly thanks to ongoing measures to reduce CO2 emissions. Exhibitors participate in the Gamescom Goes Green initiative by reusing their booth builds or avoiding single-use material. And yes, fans are planting more and more trees in the Gamescom forest. The forest has been growing since 2020 thanks to all of your engagement. And all of you can still help, of course. You can plant your tree in the Gamescom forest today. And with that, it is time to reveal the winner of the Gamescom Sustainability Award. This award celebrates an organization in the global game industry committed to sustainability and the environment. Presenting the award, please welcome back Lisa Puck with Playing for the Planet.
And okay, hello, Gamescom. Thank you for having me again.
Well, it is our absolute pleasure, Lisa.
Say the environment.
And in case some people don't know and need a quick refresher, Lisa represents Playing for the Planet, an alliance of gaming organizations committed to taking climate action under the official umbrella of the United Nations. So how are things, Lisa?
Things are going great, thank you. With 3.3 billion people around the world playing video games, we encourage everyone to make a difference wherever possible.
Absolutely, and 3.3 billion players is so, so much. So do you have any tips for our players on supporting this great initiative?
Yes, definitely. It's as easy as remembering to set up energy-saving modes to avoid unnecessary energy consumption, or switching to renewable energy electricity services at home to reduce your carbon footprint. Everything will make a difference.
Absolutely, every bit helps. Those are great tips, and I already utilize some of those myself, and I hope a lot more people will. But now, let's celebrate some of the amazing work already done by gaming companies.
Yes, that would be happy to do that. Anyone can set ambitious decarbonization targets, but delivering on that goal and turning it into emission reductions demands a clear and actionable plan, as well as collaboration. And this year's winner has proven that it's possible to deliver ambition with execution across the board. And this year's winner of the Gamescom Sustainability Award is Tencent Games. And here to accept the award is Brent Irvine, the vice chairman of Tencent Games.
Okay, bring him out.
First of all, let me say on behalf of Tencent Games how honored we are to receive this award. Tencent Games encompasses a lot of things, you know, everything from in-house studios like Timmy, global studios like Shark Mob, to our global publishing arm, Level Infinite. What they all share is a commitment to operating our business in a sustainable way. We are committed to carbon neutrality by 2030, and really want to thank all of our studios, all of our partners, but most of all of our players, whose support is essential to helping us drive our efforts to have positive change within the industry. Thanks again, and back to the games.
Congratulations, Tencent and Brent Irvine. But that is not our only award. Everyone here and at home can vote for their favorite games playable at Gamescom in this year's Gamescom Awards. You can visit Gamescom now to help decide the winners. Voting will only be open until Thursday, August 22nd at 2 p.m., and the awards will then be celebrated this Friday at 2 p.m. at Gamescom Studio. Back to you, Jeff.
Thank you, Shox. You're doing a great job tonight. All right, we got something really special for you. Please welcome Deadpool director, creator of Love, Death, and Robots, and the co-founder of Blur Studio, Tim Miller.
All right.
Thank you, Jeff. Blur Studio has been making cinematics for over 30 years now. That means classics like Quake, Star Wars, Warhammer, Call of Duty, and dozens more. And we do this because we fucking love video games. And every time a trailer comes online, we see hundreds and hundreds of comments from the fans, like, why don't we see a movie like this? Or why can't we have a series like this? And we could not agree more, which is why we are so excited to share this series with you. 15 original episodes created in collaboration with Amazon Studios and the publishers and developers of some of the world's greatest games. I'm talking new titles, existing games, indies, and classics. So we've been working on this show for 3 years. I get a little upset, choked up, sorry. I cry a lot. All right. All right, we've been working on it for 3 years. And I'm very emotional because I'm so excited. And it's finally time, so please enjoy the world premiere teaser of Secret Level.
That's
it
a name.
Is our love letter to games. And you can watch the series on Amazon Prime Video on December 10th, not too far now. So enjoy.
All
Thank
right.
you.
waited for your arrival. It is you. You will open the door. Because you are the chosen. All those moments. It's a new adventure. No matter what armies you face, what power you wield, or what creatures you unleash, we trust you will find a way to write your own legend.
Alsara Guard and Havoc threatens the balance of the world. The Alsara Guard is a tempest of disorder, sowing chaos wherever it roams. But we are honed strike at their very core. Havoc has cutting-edge technology, but is built on exploitation and suffering. United, we will plunge into the chaos to find the spark of peace. We are GTI. No one gets left behind.
Which we are announcing is coming to Steam Next Fest in October in advance of its early access release later this year. All right, let's head back to the Middle Ages for a new look at Kingdom Come Deliverance 2 with its authentic rendition of 15th century Bohemia as an action role-playing game.
I
have concluded a very fragile truce with Sigismund. And if anyone should disrupt my plans with headstrong acts of violence, there will be consequences.
I intend to wage war, not parley.
Everything all right, eh?
We need more people.
The best thing would be to recruit from your old comrades.
Well, if they're not already swinging on the gallows somewhere.
Will you help us, Henry?
From that game coming this week during Gamescom. Now, last month, the ARPG Zenless Zone Zero was released from Hoyoverse, and now we've got the debut of a brand new area of New Eridu. Check it out.
General Bei Xiao? I know her well.
You do? I know all her deeds on the battlefield by heart, such as when General Bei Xiao fought her way in and out of enemy ranks 7 times. With a single strike, she knocked down 100 enemies. 1,000. No, 10,000. Huh? You're exaggerating.
Leaving nothing but rubble.
This is what my online friends found at the scene. Look! In the form of a beast rushing forward like lightning, General Bei Xiao shouted among the ruins!
Are you my master?
That's complete nonsense. Nonsense? I have even more impressive stories.
Little girl, do you know how to get to the seat of divine foresight?
There's a fun little tease, and that was a new look at the space fantasy of Honkai Star Rail and Fei Xiao, a female general known for her prowess in martial arts. Okay, now we're heading to the Arkhamverse for Batman Arkham Shadow. It arrives later this year and is a completely new Arkham story exclusive to MetaQuest 3. I played a demo of this, and I have to say the team, Camouflage, has done an incredible job bringing the world and combat into VR. And here is your first look at the actual gameplay, a gameplay trailer for Batman Arkham Shadow.
Yes.
Rat cult spreads through Gotham like a plague. I have to stop it, even if it consumes me.
The corrupt system has failed you. Are you not angry? Fight back.
It's the freaking bat!
We are afraid of you! The bat dies tonight!
Jim, this Rat King could be anywhere. A face in the crowd, a foot soldier in his own fanatical mob. So how in the hell do we find him?
Targets are all city employees. Civil servants, public officials.
You could have been more than a symbol. You could have been a god.
Look out!
You don't calm down. Someone's going to die.
Alfred, we tried it your way. Now we do it mine.
Something big's going down tonight. We repress our rage. Our fears. It feeds the shadow deep inside us.
You're everything that's wrong with Gotham!
I'm done holding back.
I can bring the Rat King to you.
During this week of games, and this weekend the heart of our beloved gaming metropolis Cologne will transform into the vibrant Gamescom City Festival. There will be great music on three stages in the city center of Cologne on both days with another 100,000 guests. Now if you haven't been there yet, you should definitely go and check it out. That is what's happening in Cologne, and also people from more than 100 countries are here. But Gamescom has fans all over the world, and I have good news. Gamescom is heading to other continents. The first Gamescom LATAM took place in June and exceeded all of our expectations with over 100,000 fans immersed in the gaming universe. It was a fantastic show, and next year it's going to be even bigger. And Gamescom Asia returns this October. You can join in on the fun in the entertainment area to find out all about the games, the stage shows, cosplay, and much, much more. The ticket shop is already open, or you can also tune in to our online show Primetime on October 17th. Now, who is ready for another world premiere? Announced last year at ONL, here is a new look at Little Nightmares 3.
Okay, we gave more information about Little Nightmares 3.
Thank you.
3. Okay, so we got more information about that. For Firewatch?
Like that one? That's a beautiful game. Hurdling from Panic and Okamotive, and I'm so glad we could share that with you tonight. All right, Gamescom, we have a special guest joining us next. I grew up playing his games, and many of you did too. Titles like Populous, Dungeon Keeper, Magic Carpet, Theme Park, Black and White, and Fable. And tonight, he's here to reveal his brand new game.
Wait, I play Fable.
Which he's secretly been working
Fable
on
once.
For the past 3 years. Please join me, Gamescom, in welcoming to ONL Peter Molyneux.
Wait, so you're the one that made me?
Wow.
He's back!
What an incredible honor it is to be here on the stage with Jeff.
Yes, Peter.
It is amazing.
This is so fun. So a couple months ago, you and I had lunch in London. I was like, what are you working on? You're like, well, I've actually been working on a game for a number of years. You've kept very quiet about it.
Yep.
You really wanted to let the game speak for itself. But tell us about Masters of Albion.
Right. So
Masters of Albion.
After messing around on mobile, what the hell was I doing? I thought to myself, I need to come home. I need to come home to PC and console. So I've looked at Dungeon Keeper. I've taken some things that I've wanted to explore further with Dungeon Keeper. I've done the same with Black and White. I've taken things from Black and White. I've done the same with Fable. And this is what I'm showing tonight.
Well, and to your credit, you've self-funded this project yourself.
Yeah.
You put together a team of a lot of veterans from those games.
Yeah, I mean, I think my first realization is I needed to bring the old team back together again. So I'm working with people like Mark Healy and Russell Shaw and Ian Wright, the people that helped on and created Black and White, Dungeon Keeper, and Fable. Anyway, let's have a look at Masters of Albion.
All right, here's the world premiere, Masters of Albion, from Peter Molyneux.
This is Masters of Albion. We're a team of 20 people dedicated to making something new, unique, and different. Here we are in the familiar, vast world of Albion, packed with stories, quests, treasures, and monsters. This is Oak Ridge. By day, you're tasked with building the town up, gaining resources, and earning money. By night, your town will be attacked by many of Albion's creatures. You can design anything. The food that people eat, the clothes they wear, the weapons they use, the armor they fight with. There is a strategy behind every creation. I can even feed them rats. My town's working hard to make their food. They can help out, or not. I can also design, customize, and create all buildings.
Thank you.
Night is coming. The sun is going down. And now my town needs defending against the horrors of Albion. And this is my hero's time to shine.
Okay, I can see
you. You don't have to play
Lubin,
Bagel
Engine.
At any point, you
can
possess
it.
A character and play in third person. My hero is now under my complete control. And now it's time to fight. My hero's getting overwhelmed. Let's switch back to God mode and unleash some real power.
You have how the magic working stuff. Totally,
okay,
I see a little bit of Fable Engine
there.
Now,
let's design a better weapon for my hero. You can be as silly as you want, but bread swords just won't cut it. This is just a glimpse of Masters of Albion. An open-world god game full of combat, choices, mystery, and story. It's available to wishlist on Steam now.
Management offers a reminder. We're all here to have fun.
Squid Gang?
Player has been eliminated.
Squid Gang?
I've been here before, in the fold. Countless times. Who I was, who I might become. All possible futures existing in motion. It is time.
For this game. This game looks like a freaking movie. Yeah, Xbox One. Thank you.
The Marlowe's Warlord's Retreat has brought peace to the region.
Control
to
target area and get what's in that safe. The items are valuable, but you must extract alive.
Run, Natasha! They're all missing! I'm ready for a war mission! A war mission!
Thank you.
Breakout Infinite is now available in early access with the full release coming at the end of the year. Now, over the years, Blizzard has been a big part of Gamescom history, and this week we are thrilled to welcome them back for the first time since 2019. And to tell us more, here's the president of Blizzard, Johanna Ferris.
All right.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Welcome to Gamescom.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having us on behalf of Blizzard. This is such a massive moment, but it's such a special time to be sharing it here with everyone at Gamescom, and we're just really honored and grateful to be here.
Well, we're very glad to have you guys back, and I know you got a big booth with Xbox, right?
We do, yes, and come on by if you're here all week long. We're proud of it. But it's also a particularly big moment for Warcraft. We have celebrations and anniversaries galore across Hearthstone, across Rumble, and of course, a very big milestone for World of Warcraft this year.
Yes, speaking of World of Warcraft, The War Within, its global launch is coming up very soon this month, right?
Yes, it is, and we're just days away from the global launch of The War Within. August 26th, it's go time for that, and in 2 days, we'll actually open up early access for players, so we're psyched about it. Come on in and join. And I just want to say it's masterful work from the team. The World Soul Saga opens up such ambitious creative territory for us, arguably some of the most ambitious we've ever seen since WoW initially released 20 years ago. And we can't wait to embark on it and share it with players.
Yeah, it's very exciting that this month is time for that. But I know this, as you said, there's so many Warcraft anniversaries, Blizzard anniversaries, Warcraft anniversaries. How can players be a part of this?
Yeah, there's a ton of ways we're going to be able to celebrate, so we definitely hope that you join us. There will be in-game events that commence in October, so there will be more details on that, but players will be able to earn really cool in-game rewards, and we'll be finding some creative ways to celebrate the history of Azeroth together. And also, be on the lookout for our very first Warcraft Direct, where the team will share more in the coming months on all the things going on for the Warcraft universe.
Okay, well, that's exciting. Now, I was wondering about, you know, all the other Blizzard teams. Are they going to get in and celebrate these anniversaries too?
They are. There will be some nice surprises along the way, but I do want to shout out tonight the Overwatch 2 team.
Okay.
They've been doing some amazing work to show their honoring of World of Warcraft and the legacy that it brings. There will be a new collab in September. We wanted to share tonight with all of you a sneak peek of the very first new skin. It's Widowmaker, and she's embracing her allegiance for the Horde as Sylvanas Windrunner. So be on the lookout for more details from the Overwatch team on that.
Okay, thanks for bringing a little scoop along with you. That's fantastic. Now let's move to another franchise that has a big year, Diablo.
Oh yes, all eyes on October 8th. Yes, we are super excited for the Vessel of Hatred, and we're even more excited that here at Gamescom this week will be the chance to have the first ever live hands-on experience with our very new Spirit Warden class. It's beautiful, it's awesome to play, and it's definitely a key part of what makes the Vessel of Hatred so special for us.
All right, well, I understand you might have brought a little something special with you as well.
We have. Here's a look at our mercenary companions, so take a look on behalf of the Vessel of Hatred.
Desolation. Horror. This is the road we know in Sanctuary. However, some of us have taken a different path. Bound by secrecy, ready to stand and fight for those who seek us out.
My shield is your protection.
There was a time we fought the vilest of until we were left with only our inner demons. But the return of hatred has pulled us back into the light.
Your blood feeds my blade!
And though we now wait, watching from the shadows, cannot escape who we are. Why we fight.
Please, no! Stay away!
Or the fury that burns within us. I have your back.
I'm with you.
I will not let you down.
Stay back!
I am your redemption.
I am your vengeance.
I am your rage.
We are the Pale Hand, and we are the reason you need.
That looks great. Thanks for the sneak peek.
Of course, and it's my esteemed pleasure to introduce Brent Gibson, game director of Diablo IV, Vessel of Hatred.
Hello, Gamescom! The team and I are so proud that Diablo IV is the type of game that has something for all gamers. And in Vessel of Hatred, it's no exception. We are hard at work at adding new ways to play and new ways to grow in power, like mercenaries. Ordinary people with extraordinary skills that you can hire to fight alongside you in your battle against hell. We're also adding the Kurost Undercity, an all-new multi-layered dungeon that gives you the control on the types of challenges you're gonna see, as well as the rewards you may get. And we also have the Dark Citadel, our brand new co-op PvE dungeon that challenges everything you know about combat in Diablo through a gauntlet of multiplayer puzzles and mechanics. We're talking about all of it right here at Gamescom. And so stay tuned if you want to see all the things that you're going to see in Vessel of Hatred launching October 8th. And I hope to see every single one of you on the floor all the way through the show. So thank you very much. See you on the floor.
Thanks, Brent. All right, now we're heading to the hardcore action role-playing world of the first Berserker Kazan, set for 2025 release. Intense combat meets breathtaking 3D cell animation in a brutal world from Nexon. Coming to PC and console, let's witness the chaos that awaits.
The two wolves.
Okay, this is sick. Yeah, this is gonna be sick.
We'll tear into the neck of the aged lion.
For years, I faced unrelenting fury, made countless sacrifices. Result of my devotion was betrayal.
Early 2025.
The constraints of the past are history. Here, you rule the way you've always wanted. Your choices will remake the world. And every turn becomes an opportunity to triumph.
Mobile is now available for global pre-registration. Now from NetEase Games, this next trailer is a new life simulation game where players can travel among super-powered worlds to craft their island and engage with friends. Let's take a look.
We got another game to show you, which will take you on an epic global adventure. Indiana Jones and the Great Circle. Check this out.
What if I told you there was a connection between ancient cultures around the world? A Great Circle. Does it exist? Is it the key to some lost power? That's up to you to uncover. I'm Troy Baker, and I play Indy. It's humbling playing a character that so many people, myself included, look up to. As a kid, seeing Indiana Jones in the theater for the first time was a defining moment for me. And I never would have guessed that all these years later, I would be the one wearing the hat. But here I am. It's been a dream come true. A dream that I cannot wait for you to live for yourselves. The beauty of a first-person game like this is that We all get to feel what it's like to become indie. You are the one who cracks the whip, who feels the weight of every punch and the thrill of finding every clue. Indie is such a unique character. Professor, an archaeologist, a brawler, an explorer, the quintessential all-around adventurer. And this game has everything you'd expect from an Indiana Jones adventure. Mysterious artifacts, cunning villains, ancient discoveries, hard-hitting action. It's a world of constant danger where you've got to think on your feet to stay alive. The Great Circle spans the entire globe, from snake-filled jungle temples to scorpion-riddled desert tombs. Stunning open areas to explore freely, full of secrets for you to discover. And you'll get more than just the classic whip and revolver. Indy's journal and his camera will immerse you in the mystery, providing extra info on all of your finds so you can appreciate all of the little historical details he obsesses over. And those details are your key to solving the ancient puzzles that hold the secrets you're after. But ancient secrets don't come easy. It's best to have an exit strategy. This is an incredible new way to experience Indiana Jones, and I can't wait for you to play it. Hold on to your hat.
Doesn't that look great? A world of mystery to explore, but you're probably wondering when the game comes out, right? Well,
December the 9th, 2024.
There you have it. Indiana Jones and the Great Circle is coming out this December for Xbox, Game Pass, and PC. But there is one more thing that Machine Games and Bethesda wanted to share with you about Indiana Jones and the Great Circle.
Spring 2025, PS5.
The game's coming to PlayStation 5 in spring of 2025.
Oh.
All right, before we wrap up O&L, we do have one final game announcement for you. Check this out.
This thing of ours, it's a brotherhood. Treachery. And deceit. Do you wish to commit yourself, your life, to this?
Mafia, the old country. What? Seymour, December 2024.
I'm Nick Baines, president of Hangar 13. What you just saw is the first early look at Mafia, the old country. A thrilling story set in 1900 Sicily during the origins of the Mafia. We're going back to the roots of what fans love about the Mafia franchise, crafting a deep linear narrative with that classic mob movie feeling. Mafia's success is built
okay.
on our players' passion.
All right, we're bringing back.
And we're so
they're trying
proud
to bring back the
Mafia
series.
With the old country. We can't wait to show you all more. Thanks for watching.
All right. That's okay.
That was
a lot
surprise,
of fun.
Right? All right. Well, that
I
is a wrap on opening night live from here in Cologne, Germany. And we hope to see you again this December, December 12th, when the Game Awards streams live.
Remember this, make sure you like and subscribe and comment.
Special night as we give
and
you a
tell
sense
me what
of where
game he was
going in
for.
The next decade. We don't want to say much now, but trust me, it's going to be a very special show. All right, well, thanks again to my co-host, Shox. Didn't you do a great job?
Thank you so much, Jeff. It was really great to be here. I hope everyone had an amazing time. And can I say something in German, too?
Good.
Don't want to show you up, but vielen Dank, ihr Lieben. Ich hoffe, ihr habt eine super, super Zeit und viel Spaß auf der Gamescom.
Well done, German, as opposed to mine. I'm learning. All right. Thanks so much, Shox. Thanks to everyone. Enjoy Gamescom. Have a great night.